When you and I have a difficulty, we're supposed to have sabr. You don't have sabr when you're happy. You're supposed to have sabr when you're upset, when something is wrong, when something goes badly. Look at the language of Allah Azza wa Jalla. He says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Congratulate the people who have sabr. Subhanallah. Why? Because of the belief. For a believer, the attitude is entirely different. Maybe the whole ordeal, the entire trouble you are going through, the goal of it all was one thing. So you could have sabr. Because if you can have sabr, you are worthy of congratulations. We think the goal was this thing you were going to get in dunya. Maybe I thought the goal was to get the job. Maybe I thought the goal was to make the sale. But maybe to Allah, the real goal is you were going to learn sabr. That's a bigger goal than anything else. Subhanallah. And if you got that goal, you should be congratulated. Everything you get in this life is then a gift. It's not something you earned, it's a gift. So when you don't have it, then you realize, well, it wasn't mine anyway. It wasn't mine anyway. We take our hands for granted, we take our eyes for granted, we take our nose for granted, we take our tongue for granted. The fact that I'm standing here speaking before you, I take the fact that I can speak to you for granted. But this tongue, it doesn't belong to me. I didn't pay for it. It belongs to Allah. So when it starts stuttering, inna lillah, inna lillah. The wisdom of the statements Allah gave us when difficulty comes. The second statement is, wa inna ilayhi raji'un. No doubt about it, to Him alone we're going to be returning. Why is that important? Because whatever problem you're having right now isn't permanent. Whatever problem you're having isn't permanent. Whether it's money problems or health problems or family problems, or it's emotional problems or physical problems, it doesn't matter. None of them are permanent. You know why? Because you and I are not permanent. Recap of everything. First of all, the first thing when difficulty happens, train your tongue, train your heart. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. That's number one. Number two, don't say to other people that something is happening to them because of Allah. Don't say this to people. Do not say this to people. If you want to say that to people, before you think of anyone else, think about yourself. You don't get to decide something happened from the ghaib, something happened from Allah, and you don't get to decide why did Allah do this, that He didn't offer His explanation to you. You don't have that license. And when it comes to ourselves, we have to make the distinction between things that are out of our hands, you can't control them, then we say, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. And the things that are within our control, we have to take our own responsibility. We have to acknowledge the fact that we were the ones who messed up. We were the ones who should have done better. This is as a result of our own misbehavior. May Allah Azza wa Jalla make us of those who pass all of these tests and are meeting with Him with light in our chests and light coming out of our right hands on the Day of Judgment. Love is all we need. Love is all we need.